Now let us learn about vegetative propagation in plants. So if you see in plant, there are two parts. One is the vegetative parts of a plant, the other is the reproductive parts of a plant. Now what comes under vegetative parts? So roots, stems, buds, nodes. So if the plant reproduces by these vegetative parts, we call such a reproduction as vegetative propagation.
Now we'll see vegetative propagation by modified roots. So what are actually modified roots? That is, these roots are actually swollen roots. It is because food is stored in them. So for example, you can have a sweet potato, dahlia. So these are the examples for modified roots. So here, when such swollen roots or modified roots are buried in the soil, new plants are obtained. The next is vegetative propagation by modified underground stems. For example, potato, ginger, onion. So these are modified underground stems with the swollen stems because they stored food. Now if you observe here potato, you can find the eyes of this potato. So when they are placed in the soil, they start producing the new buds. This is a germinating eye bud and it develops into a new plant. Whereas if you observe here ginger, so here these ginger, when it is kept on into the soil, the buds here that are produced, you can observe here small buds. These buds under favorable condition produce new plants. So the same way here, the onion bulb also can grow into a new plant. So the next one is vegetative reproduction by aerial stem. So this method generally you can see in grass or strawberry plant, where there is a slender branch so that the stem is almost horizontal or parallel to the soil. So here this stem, when it touches the soil, it develops buds and roots, and then this bud develops into a new plant. Now vegetative reproduction by adventitious buds on leaves. So this method is seen in bryophyllum leaf, which contains adventitious buds in their notches. So here you can observe, these are the notches of the leaf. So there you can find adventitious buds on their margins, and these buds develop into new plants when they are grown. Next we will learn about artificial methods of vegetative propagation. So the first method here is cutting. So you, in this method, a small piece of stem from a plant having the leaf buds is cut and placed in the moist soil so that it will develop roots and grows into a new plant. And there are many advantages in this method. So a large number of plants can be produced from one plant, and it can be produced within very short span of time, and the new plants that are produced are exact copies of the parent plant. The next method is layering. So in this method, generally the branches should be flexible so that the lower branch of the plant is bent. So you can find here a bent branch into the moist soil or into the ground. Then after some time, the roots are developed and a new plantlet is produced. So this is called layer. The newly formed plant is called layer. So later, this newly formed plant and the parent plant is separated. So in this method, the plants which are chosen for grafting should be made an incision. The stem should be cut in a particular pattern so that each should fit into each other. So here you can observe there is a pattern of cut, and they are fixed together and tied together so that they grow as a single plant. Now the plant which has its own root system, we call such plant as stock plant. Then the other plant which is chosen for grafting, we call it as graft or scion. Now, the fourth method is tissue culture. So, in this method, a small piece of tissue is cut from the plant and then it is placed in an artificial medium. Now, if you observe, this is a petri dish or a glass plate which contains nutrient medium. That means all the requirements that is required for the tissue to grow. So, then the tissue develops into a mass of cells. We call it as callus. So, this callus, later it is transferred into a test tube containing nutrient medium which forms root system and develops into a small plantlet. So, later this is transferred onto a pot or into the soil which can develop into a plant or which promotes further growth in that plant.
So, let us see the advantages of artificial vegetative propagation. So, in this method, more number of plants can be produced with very less cost. And the second advantage is the same identical copies of plants can be produced within very short span of time. And then, in this method, new varieties of plants can be produced. And the fourth advantage is plants which cannot produce through seeds can be produced by this method.